You can see that this is already in slope-intercept form, right? Mx plus b. It's kind of the my little secret to graphing these inequalities. Right. So we see the y-intercept of 5. Right? Y-intercept of 5. A slope of 3. So let's show a slope of 3. They don't have enough room here to go this way, so we'll go down 3 to the left one. We'll point there. So they followed the y-intercept of the slope, and then they drew this line. What do you notice about this line?
It's dotted.
It's dotted. Why is it dotted?
Because that means it is close to it, but not on it.
Right. Because what happens if you pick a point that's on the line, and you use that x and y in this inequality?
It won't work.
Why not?
Because it has to be less than.
So why does it?
Why will points from the line not work in this inequality?
Because it's not less than.
What is it?
Exactly.
Exactly. Yeah, it's exactly the same. Any point you pick from the line, you put it into this inequality, it makes both sides exactly the same. Can it be exactly the same?
No.
No, it doesn't have a little or equal to there, right? So they can't be the same. Just to prove my point, let's choose this point. It's at negative 1, 2. Right, so y is 2, and x is negative 1. 2, is that less than this side? Well, 3 times negative 1 is negative 3, plus 5, 3. Negative 3 plus 5 is 2. Just like Cameron said, both sides are exactly the same. Neither is greater than or less than the other side. And since this side needs to be less than that side, this is a false statement. So any point that's right on the line will make this the same on both sides, and we don't want that. But this part is shaded in. How do you suppose they figured out that was the side they were supposed to shade in? How do we learn that? How do we learn which side is shaded?
Whichever side is greater.
Whichever side is greater. Whichever side has points that make this true.
Yes.
How do we figure out if this side is the side with all the points we want, or this is the side with all the points that we want?
As the
So how do we figure out which points make this side less than this side?
The 3x plus 4.
I'm not sure what you mean by that. How do we figure out that all the points that with like this x and this y, or this x and this y, or this x and this y, will make this side less than this side? First, let's see if they're right. They've shaded in this side. This side's gray, right? Let's see if they're right. How can we check and see if they're right?
By putting in the points for y.
The points for, yeah, putting the x and the y from, should do it for all of the points, right? That's impossible. But we can pick one of the points, and all the other points should work as well that are on that same side of the line. So let's choose this one. This is at 2, right? X is 2. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Y is 5. So we'll choose that point. 2, 5. So 5 for y. Is that less than what we get over here? 3 times 2 plus 5. I can't see how it couldn't be, right? We already have 5 plus some more. That's definitely going to be bigger than 5. Let's keep going. 3 times 2 is 6 plus 5. 5 less than 11. Is 5 less than 11?
Yes.
Then the guy whose job it was to put this answer in the book is not wrong. Right? He's shading the correct side. Right? And if I choose 3, 5, then that'll also be true. Right? 1, 5, that'll also be true. So this point works, and that one, and that one, and that one. These ones work. All of these points on this side of the line work. And all the sides, all the points on this side of the line will not work. Okay? If we weren't testing to make sure that the guy who put the answer in the book was correct, it wasn't shaded yet, how could we figure out that is the side we were supposed to shade? 2 points?
Yeah,
just find 2 points. Okay, so like choose one from over here, choose one from over here. The one that works is the side that you shade, the one that doesn't is the side you don't shade, right? But if that's true, do we need 2 points?
You just
it's just easier to make sure.
Okay, just like a double check. Just to double check, sure. But if we always do everything correct and all we really have to do is decide which side is supposed to have all the points colored in, then we just need to choose one point. If it works, then that's the side we shade. If it doesn't work, shade the other side. And my suggestion was that you choose this point as often as you can, right? Because that point is what?
Zero
for x and zero for y. Can't get much easier than that, right? Zero is less than, well, that's zero plus five. Is zero less than five?
Yes.
Yeah, so this point is on the side that you should shade. That's how this guy figured out.
It's pretty much where the point is you would shade it.
If it worked. Yeah. If it didn't work, you just go to the other side. Same thing here, real quick. We've got a y-intercept of 8, 2, right? 2, 4, 6, 8. There it is, y-intercept of 8. Slope of negative 2 over 1. So they went to the right one and down 2. There's another point. And they made it a, what kind of line?
That's a negative line.
It's got a negative slope. But what's different from this line and this line?
It's not dotted.
Not dotted. Solid. Why is it solid?
Because it could be equal to.
Because it's got the little equal to condition, it can be equal to. Right? So if both sides are equal, that's okay. In this case, if both sides are equal, it's not okay. But it is okay here, that's why we show it a solid line. It's a line made of filled in dots. This is it's almost like a line made of not filled in circles. Right? It's kind of like that. So we figured out that it has a y-intercept of 8. Oh, you know what? The scale here is 2 for everything. Go over 1, which would actually be halfway there, and 2, of course that's the same. This is going over 4 and going down 8. Or going over 2 and going down 4. Or you can go over 4 and going down 8. So we found the line, we've made it solid because it can be equal, both sides can be equal. And then we just need to figure out which side to shade. If we didn't know that this side was supposed to be shaded already, we can choose this point, 0, 0. Right. And you can tell just because there's the answer right there. Is this point going to work?
No.
It's not going to work. It's not on the side that you know should be shaded. So we put a 0 in for y and a 0 in for x. We just get 8 on this side. Is 0 bigger than 8? 0 greater than 8. Is it equal to 8? No. So we know that that's not the side we want to shade. We want to shade on this side, which we can see is the answer. With this one, you can add 4 to both sides to get it in mx plus b. Y is less than x minus 2. Got a y-intercept of negative 2, a slope of 1. Dotted line, because it does not have an equal to sign. Test point of 0, 0. It won't work. We shade on the other side. Here again, we can distribute, move it around, mess with it until y is by itself on one side. It looks like y equals mx plus b. Graph it. Dotted line because it's not equal to test point. If it works, shade it in. If it doesn't, shade the other side. Okay. You guys think that you can do it on your own? Alright. Let's get out a piece of paper and prepare for that. Remember, we found out by trial and error. We did this first class, we reviewed last class. We always get a line, right? We started with that example way back in the day of x plus y needs to be, I think, greater than 5. Found a bunch of points that made both sides, actually made both sides equal, and we found that those points that made both sides equal made up a line, right? We started to see a line take shape. And then we saw a bunch of other points that were on the other, like on one side of the line, but not the other side. So we found a line, and then we found that there was, to make it a quick way of saying this, shading. There's a bunch of points on one side of the line that make, in this case, this side bigger than the 5. So for us, there's going to be some line that if we plug in that x and the y from any point on the line, it's going to make both sides equal. Okay. And if we look at other points that are not on the line, on one side or the other, there are a bunch of points that are going to make this side greater than this side, right? And the points on the other side are going to make this less. So first we need to find that line. We've graphed lines like this so many times. That line is this, right? It's all the solutions to this equation. And that equation happens to be part of this inequality, right? There's the equation, and there's, you know, in addition, there's this greater than piece. So, we're looking to graph that y equals negative 3/4 x plus 2. How do we graph y equals, I'll learn it again, y equals negative 3/4 x plus 2, all of those points that make those sides equal. How do we graph that equation? Find a point that's on the line. Okay, how do we find a point that's on the line?
Have x be 0.
Let x be 0, and y will be?
2.
0, 2, right? That's our, what's that point called? Everybody got the name for that point that's on the y-axis? So we need another point then, or we need, I mean, we could look at it a different way. How would we go about graphing the rest of this line?
We could just go down 3 and then to the left 4.
So it would be either down 3 and to the right 4, or up 3 and to the left 4. That's how we get a negative slope. So go down 3, 1, 2, 3, right there, and to the right 4, 1. Which would be the same as, just as you pointed out, you could plug in 0 and get 2. You could plug in 4, right, which would cancel the denominator there. Y equals negative 3/4 times 4 over 1 plus 2. Okay, so we get negative 3 plus 2, negative 1 like that. Put in 4 for x, we got a negative 1 for y. Just double confirm that. So here we have this line. This line is made of an infinite number of points, and all of these points, if I pick a point from that line, it will make both sides equal. That's why we filled in this line, because this line is great, because it gives us these points where both sides are equal. Can both sides be equal? When you look up there at the problem?
Yes.
Yeah, we got the little equals 2 part. So yes, it's going to be solid, because those points are good. We like those points. Okay. Now either this half or this half is just tons of infinite numbers of points where the x and the y, when you plug in the x here and the y here, the y side is greater than this side. How do we decide which side that is? Which side has all the points that we want?
The one that works.
Okay, so we need to find one that works. How do we do that?
Choose a point.
Particular point, right? You could choose a point at random. You just throw a dart at the graph, wherever it hits, try that point. And if it works, it must be from the half that works. And if it doesn't, it must be from the half that doesn't work. So we throw a dot, and not so randomly, I have a dart. I have my dart laying right there at 0, 0. This is 0 for x and 0 for y. It's just so convenient. So 0 for y, greater than or equal to negative 3/4 times 0 plus 2. Is 0 greater than or equal to 2?
Nope.
Oh, so this point must be
wrong.
Wrong, right? Which means the points that are right must be where? Up here, yeah, on the top side of the line. So all these guys here. So we don't have time to draw dots until all this is filled in. I shade it. Scribbling on that side. That scribbling is really representing that I'm imagining I filled in all of those points all individually. Okay. So let's graph the inequalities in two variables. We always wind up with a line. That's the line that's made up of all the points that make both sides exactly the same. And the shading, that would be all of the points that make it not the same, but it makes it unequal in the way that we want. It makes this side larger than this side. And all the points, no matter where you pick them, whether it be this point, or this point, or this point that's just barely off the line right there, all those points are going to have this side be bigger than this side. This point, this point, this point, and this point, and this point, none of those are going to work. All of those are going to have this side be bigger than this side. So find the line, test the point, and you'll know which side to shade. Graph the line, test the point. Right? Any questions?